probability distribution of a continuous random variable. Now, in case of continuous random variable, probability distribution can be represented or can be presented in either formula form or graphical form. Now, in previous case, in case of discrete random variable, we had presented probability distribution in terms of tabular form, that for each value of x, we had some probability, that p of x, and we had represented it in tabular form, right? But in case of continuous probability distribution, we can represent it either in formula form or graphical form. So basically, what is probability distribution? Suppose this is your probability distribution function. Okay, suppose this is your probability distribution function. Now the area under this is nothing but probability distribution function. So for value, suppose let me take this as C or let me take this as D. Okay, so the area under this curve is nothing but probability distribution for interval C to D. Now whenever we talk about continuous random variable, it will be always in terms of intervals, whereas if it is discrete, it will be to the particular point. Now in case of discrete, like for example, suppose we are talking about tossing a or throwing a die. Okay, suppose we are talking about throwing a die. So for random variable 1, we have probability 1 upon 6. For random variable 2, we have probability again 1 upon 6. Suppose we are talking about a coin, suppose 0 head, and for 0 head we have 1 upon 2, for 1 head we have 1 upon 2, right? So whenever we talk about discrete random variable, basically we talk about particular points, wherein in case of continuous random variable, we talk about particular interval, like from C to D or from D to another E. Okay, so this area is nothing but probability distribution of for this particular function from C to D, for interval C to D. Okay, so we are taking values from the interval in case of continuous random variable, wherein in case of discrete random variable we are taking particular point. Now a function p of x is said to be probability density function of a continuous random variable x if it satisfies the following properties. Now first property, probability of every function, every variable has to be greater than or equals to 0. No matter what x you are choosing from this particular interval a to b, probability of that particular variable has to be always greater than or equals to 0. Next, for two distinct numbers c and d in the interval a comma b, probability of C to D can be calculated by area under the probability curve from the ordinates x equals to C to x equals to D. Basically, these vertical lines, so area in between these vertical lines C to D is nothing but probability from C to D. We can even calculate this using integration, that is area. Okay, suppose I'm calculating probability from C to D, it is probability from C to D, it is nothing but integral from C to D of this particular function P of x d. Suppose this is my P of x, so integral from C to D of this particular function is nothing but area from C to D. So this is another way of calculating area under this particular curve, which is nothing but probability from C to D, right? Next, total area under the probability curve has to be 1. Now, if this is your entire curve, from this point to the end point, the total area under the curve has to be 1. Okay. Now, if it satisfies all these three conditions, then we can say this P of x is probability density function of the continuous random variable x. So whenever we talk about probability distribution, it is nothing but this area, this total area 1 is distributed. How it is distributed? So if I calculate from C to D, it will be area in between interval C to D. Okay. So basically what we are studying here is from which point to which point or how the area is distributed under this particular function. An area of this entire curve will be always equals to 1.